Hi friends, so in this video we will be understanding some key points about RankNet and the cost function, the probabilistic cost function in which it has proposed. So why this architecture is used? So as we know that ranking of items, for example in case of search results of a query of a search engine like Google search engine, so we will be having various documents or various links which are available for the particular query. So which query should, which link or article should be ranked up from one another, so this kind of architecture is used. So it was proposed by Microsoft. Another example could be in recommendation systems, in movie recommendation systems, which movie should be rated above. So one major point for RankNet is that in case of RankNet, instead of comparing all the documents and ranking one above the other, what RankNet does is that it compares one document with another document, that is pairwise comparison is made. First point, for example, between two documents A and another document. By document I mean an article or a particular result of the query or the particular feature vector on the basis of which we will be comparing, pairwise comparison. Second, not all the documents are compared with one another, compared with each other. What happens is, for example, so we will be writing the third point as query wise comparisons are done. The third point here means that, for example, say we are having a total of 100 documents and we have to rank all these 100 documents, that which document comes above the other. So if we will be comparing one document with another, that is the first point, pairwise comparison. So how many documents can we have to compare 100 C2 documents, that is there are possibility of 100 C2 combination of documents of comparison. So it will be around 100 multiplied by 99 divided by 2. But in case of these two points are linked together in case of RankNet. So what it does is, say for a particular query, say in a Google search we are writing something and doing a query search, then we are returned only 10 documents at a time. So we have to rank only those 10 items at a particular time. So out of this 100 documents, we will be getting 10 documents from the 10 documents on doing a query for the particular thing. So we will get 10 documents. Now we have to rank only these 10 documents instead of 100. So we will be having only 10 C2 combination, that is 10 into 9 divided by 2, which is a huge less amount of comparisons. So instead of this 100 documents, there will be a very large amount of documents which will be available in real application. So now we are having 10 documents, so only these many comparisons are need to be done in order for ranking these 10 documents. And how many queries will be done? So for these 10 documents, we will be having these many comparisons. So for next 10 documents, or we can say on next query, we will be having next 10 documents. So it will be again 10 C2. So for in total for 100 documents, we will be having in total for 100 documents, we will be having 10 times we have to run the query, 10 into 10c, two combination, that is 10 into 10 into 9 divided by 2. So this is lesser in comparison to ranking those 100 documents in all together. Now the fourth point is, various ranking algorithms before RankNet used an ordinal regression in order to produce the rank. That is, ordinal regression means that we are having a document 1, say A, and document 2, say B. In case of ranking, the rank of A is say 0.7 and say the rank of B is 0.3. So now, as we can see, the score of A is larger than score of B, and having a threshold, say a threshold of 0.5, we are saying that if the score is greater than 0.5, then the rank of A will be larger than rank of B. That is, distributing the ranks of particular documents into ordinal numbers. Say we are having A and B, so we will be saying that A has a rank of 1 and B has a rank of 2. Say, and the drawback here was deciding this threshold, that what threshold, or we will be saying a particular rank boundaries that needed to be decided, is very difficult in this case. Now what RankNet does is, fourth point the RankNet does is that it does not bin the ranks. That is, it says that what is the need of ranking or giving a particular ordinal number to a document. That if we say that A has a higher rank than B, so this statement only is self-sufficient to rank A higher than B, instead of having a particular number to prove this. Now the next thing which comes in RankNet is its probabilistic ranking cost function. So first point which it assumes, or which it takes, is it takes a pair of samples, say document A and document B, in space R to the power of D, real number to the power of D, where D represents the dimension of the document feature, right? D represents the dimension of the document feature. Second point is, this pair of document has a target probability of P A B bar, but this P A B bar suggests that it is P A B bar is the probability that A has a rank higher than B. It is probability that A has a rank higher than B. Now the third point is that we are developing a function f such that from R real number of dimension D mapping to real number. This means that f is basically a function, a model, in which we will be feeding x as an input to our model. What is this x? X will be having a feature of d dimensions, and the output of our model will basically be a real number. So when we will be having input
x1, then the output of the model will be f of x1. When we will be having input x2, then the model output of the model will be f of x2. So if the input is a document A, then the output will be f of document A. Input is document B, output will be f of document B. So what RankNet here tells that if f of x1, the output from the model, comes out to be greater than f of x2, then this will mean that x1
has a higher rank than x2.
So we have seen that for document A, if f of x1 will be greater than f of x2, then it will be termed as that the document x1 has a higher rank than document x2. So what is this f? F is basically a model. It can be a deep learning model, neural network, etc. So now we will be developing the cost function, which is the cost that has to be reduced in order to predict the probability that whether the document A is higher ranked, is to be higher ranked than document B. So we write a modeled posterior probability P of xi greater than xj. This means that the probability that whether a document xi has a higher rank than xj, and it is represented by P of ij. P of ij means the probability that a document I, x of I, has a higher rank than j, and ij starts from 1 to m, where m denotes the total number of examples in our training set. Let p bar ij be the desired target values for these posterior. So this is the target probability that yes, this pair of document is true. This suggests that the document, first document A, has a higher probability than second document. Now we will be defining a term OI. This OI represents the output for the ith input. That is, if we are having an input to the model as x of I, then the output of the model will be f of xi. And oij here, oij represent the difference in the output from the model. Say we are having a document x of I, we use the features of the model in the space of r to the power of d and predict the output in the real domain, and we get a real number as output. Similarly, we take another document x of j, we put the same document inside the function and get a real number as an output. So O of ij will be represented as the real number which is outputted from the first model of first input minus the real number which is outputted from the model on giving second document x of j as input. Now we know the cross entropy cost function. So here the formula is same, but the thing is, here instead of the direct labels, we are having the probability as the output labels. In general neural network, what we see is that we are having an output label y and predicted label y hat, right? So in this case, the output is basically a probability. The probability that whether the document A has a higher rank than document B. And the true label will be also a probability that whether it is really the document A, whether really the document A is ranked higher than document B. So it is basically minus of Pij, log of Pij. Here minus of p bar ij is the probability that document A is ranked higher than document j, sorry, I is ranked higher than document j, and log of probability p of ij is the predicted probability that the document A is to be ranked higher than document B or not. Now this probability P of ij is basically mapped as a logistic function. Why logistic function? Because we are having just two cases available with us, that is 0 or 1. Here 1 indicates P of ij. If P of ij is 1, that will indicate that yes, the document I has a higher rank than the document B. It will be probability answer will be 1. That if the answer, that is P of ij, is 0, it means that the probability, it means that the document A is not to be ranked higher than document B, right? So now
if we use this equation second and put this equation in the first one, we will get this third equation. It is basically solving the log function, that is log a by b is equal to log a minus log b. So on solving log of a, that is e raised to the power o of ij, o of ij we come down, and then we will be getting this as the output, right? Now one thing we have to note here is learning to rank using neural nets, that is using the gradient descent. They are proving that the gradient descent is actually applicable on the pairwise computation of the cost, probabilistic cost function. So it is basically a two-layer neural network which they have used. It's the weights multiplied with the input x plus the biases and summation of all the neurons of that layer, again application of the activation function g, and then again multiplication with the weights and the addition of biases to get another after the application of another activation function. Now they have computed the gradients, and then the gradients will be they have computed the gradients, and after the gradients the weight updation will be carried out by using the eta, which is the learning rate, right? So this was actually the basic behind the RankNet function. The main was this cost function, the probabilistic cost function, which takes the difference of the outputs from the model and takes a probability over that, right? So we can quickly go through the code of this RankNet model. So it is basically a code which is developed in Keras. It is a very simple and short code. So here we can see two scores, a relevant document score and an irrelevant document score. So here in case of a relevant document score, it is basically can be said as a document A or X of I. An irrelevant document score can be said to be a document V or X of J. That is, we are assuming that yes, X of I has a higher rank and X of J as a lower rank. It is termed to be as an irrelevant document and then relevant document. So if the relevant document, the probability or the output from the model f of x of relevant document will be greater than f of irrelevant document, then the probability will be 1, and it indicates that the rank of document I will be greater than the rank of document J. So what we are doing is we are using three dense layers. The input features we will be having from the document, say of input dimension of 50. So if we are having a document X with features of 50, then applying dense layers, we can get an output neuron or output layer of size 1. That is why 1, because we have to just compute 0 or 1. That is whether the document A has the higher probability than B. Similarly, for the irrelevant document, we will be having an irrelevant score of size 1 at the output. Now, this is the main thing. The main thing is that we have to subtract the relevant score and the irrelevant score. That is, we are subtracting the output of the model, which we have seen as f of xi minus f of xj as o of ij. Now after this after the finding of o of ij, we will be applying an activation of sigmoid. It is basically the application of a probability or a logistic function over that. That is mapping the difference of output into 0 or 1. If it is 1, it indicates that yes, relevant document has the probability of has the rank higher than an irrelevant document. So here we are compiling the model and trained a model over the test data. So this was it. This is a simple code for the RankNet model. And if you have any doubts or queries, you can just comment below or mail me at my email ID. And thank you very much.